the Falcon heavy, too small?
Oh, just like a little baby bear's bed, just right.
Find out more on today's
Muskwatch!
Boeing shot some space lasers across SpaceX's bow.
Specifically on their Watch Us Fly website, they claim that their Space Launch System, or SLS
Souls.
For short, yes, thank you, Dan, will be the world's most powerful rocket. And they have an article about why SpaceX's Falcon Heavy is, quote, too small for NASA's deep space needs.
What a bunch of size queens. Stuart Little's convertible was still a convertible. And first off, nobody tells Daddy that he's too small.
Yeah, I think there's no real length limit.
What's a size queen?
Google it.
What the hell are you talking? Why are you laughing? What is that?
Google it.
I don't want to.
Pop a goog, dude.
Never. Is it... Are you obsessed with size? Is that what a size queen is?
Yeah, you could say that's an element.
I legitimately have no idea. Second off, these claims are misleading at best and inaccurate at worst. The first version of the SLS due out in late 2019 won't be the most powerful rocket ever made by a long shot.
Damn.
And the Falcon Heavy will be so much cheaper to operate in comparison.
Cha-ching! And the later updated version of the SLS that will be the most powerful rocket ever won't be out until the mid to late 2020s
what?
At the earliest, with no clear timeline in sight. And by that time, it won't just be competing against the Falcon Heavy, but the BFR.
It's a beast, so...
And the most interesting part of these claims was brought to our attention by Ars Technica. The link that Boeing provides to, quote, learn more about why the SLS is the right choice for NASA is an article from the London Evening Standard, a tabloid owned by a Russian billionaire and former KGB agent. Interesting.
Just to damn ya! Didn't quite land.
Yeah, that's fine.
But we'll let you decide which rocket's the better choice for NASA, the much more affordable SpaceX Falcon Heavy, which had its first successful test this February, or the SLS, which will have its first test in December 2019 at the earliest. Really?
Nobody tell us that Dad's small, because then we get mad.
Yeah, and super hot.
Yeah. Big. Although, you know, I bet it doesn't look that big after a while.
When a Tesla shareholder slash guy who makes YouTube videos about Tesla and Bitcoin petitioned Elon Musk to allow him to ask Musk a question during Tesla's first quarter earnings call, Papa Elon had a surprising answer.
You're not gonna believe it, okay?
I won't.
He said, okay.
What?
Yeah.
And we were a little shocked by this response, as I just demonstrated. As someone who's actually been to SpaceX spent quality time with the man, as evidenced by these photos.
These are tangential at best.
Yeah, tangential to
greatness.
Look, honestly, I think that you and I are much more poised to ask Daddy a question publicly.
Yep, and it's not gonna be a softball either. We aren't afraid to ask any of those hard-hitting questions.
Some real hard balls.
All right, so, questions.
What are stocks?
Yeah.
And where are you hiding all the Tesla Model 3s.
I think we need to move on to another question. My apologies.
Well, Kyle.
Yeah.
Call me Shia LaBeouf.
I'll just do it.
Because I'm itching to get behind the wheel of a new car that transforms into a giant robot called J Deity Ride.
The robot, which can transform from car to robot in 60 seconds. He's gone from car to robot in 60 seconds. Was built by Brave Robot.
Thank you.
Yeah, yeah. Awesome name, Brave Robotics. And it definitely, obviously, is a direct reference to awesome mecha anime.
Brave Robotics CEO Kenji Ishida took on this project because, as he puts it, I grew up believing that robots had to be capable of such things, which became my motivation to develop this robot, which is awesome.
Want it?
Yeah.
Live it, do it, man.
Give more otaku a shit ton of money.
Yeah, enough to buy one Tesla share, please. You probably still won't get your car. The coolest thing is that this robot drives in car mode and walks in robot mode. It's actually a transformer like we see in the movies and we were promised by so many cartoons in the 80s.
You see, walking robots walk like this and driving robots drive like this.
So relatable.
It's powered by a lithium-ion battery and they claim it can reach a top speed of 18 miles an hour while walking. and 37 miles an hour while driving.
So way faster than the average walker, but way slower than the average car, right in the middle.
Yeah, finally, filling that transportation gap between dumb humans and your mom.
Okay. Given all this, we can bet that it'll only be moments until Elon Musk announces his own transforming car to go along with cyborg dragons and whatnot. And on that note, it's time for your Musk-see moment of the week.
Oh,
Musk-see! Wow, I accelerated in way into the...
Ladies and gentlemen, he's dead.
Elon Musk took to Twitter to let us all know, quote, he didn't really say this, did he? What is he do? Whatever. He took to Twitter to let us all know, quote, I have prehensile eyebrows, end quote. Which means that his eyebrows are capable of grasping things, kind of like a monkey's tail.
Yeah, and when helpful Twitter users tweeted the fact that the long-tailed pangolin has a prehensile tail for climbing trees, Musk replied with, that's how I use my eyebrows too.
I think, Dan, this might be the next step in human evolution. Just imagine.
Oh, sick.
Just imagine. In the next couple million years,
next
humans
couple minutes.
Are able to use their facial muscles to grab onto other people's faces with their eyebrows.
Oh.
Wow.
That is like a chalky sensation in my mouth. That's genuinely terrible.
Come here.
But before I go,
I want to leave you
a disturbing image of a romantic date with Elon Musk.
Damn it.
It's going well. You're leaning in for a kiss at the end of the night when all of a sudden, out of nowhere, his f***ing eyebrows reach out and gently caress your face.
I think those are called caterpillar kisses instead of butterfly kisses. Instead of eyelashes, it's the eyebrows. Doesn't it feel good, baby?
His eyelons. And that's all the time we have for this episode of Musquatch. Bye.
Oh! I skipped leg day.
Thanks for watching this week's Musquatch. Remember to subscribe, like, and hit that bell to get notified whenever a new video drops.
Make sure to comment below with what you would name your transforming robot.
Cloptimus Prime, it turns from a horse into a centaur.
Bumble Yeezy. Half Ooh. Car, half Kanye, all crazy. And send your musky stories to @DanCasey, @SciFile, and @Nerdist with the hashtag Musquatch! I hope my knees are okay.
They're broken.